Hello everyone. Now we will have gynec lecture. In gynec, we will see today the topic that is congenital diseases seen in the females. These are the diseases which are present from birth. Congenital diseases or congenital malformations of female genital tract. These are the diseases which are seen from birth, and they are usually developed during the intrauterine life or neonatal life. So these are the types of diseases which are usually caused because of developmental defect during intrauterine life or neonatal life. This defect may be because of hereditary factor, genetic factors, because of the malnutrition, because of the severe anemia of mother, or any deficiency problems that leads to developmental defect of that baby. In some condition, it may be because of the overuse of some drugs, steroids, or any other drugs. Next is because of the major disease of that female, like heart disease, renal disease, severe diabetes, severe hypertension. So these are the things. And one more thing is patient with prolonged hormonal therapy, that mother is with prolonged hormones, and that child may have these types of congenital diseases. So these are some, again, one important thing is a patient with chemotherapy or radiotherapy, or history of chemo or radiation before pregnancy. Age factor, of course, maternal age more than 35 to 40 or less than 18. Developmental defect, we discuss about the deficiency things, lack of nutrition during pregnancy, heavy work, injuries, trauma, surgeries. These are the other factors which are responsible. Again, viral infection. There are some viral infections, rubella-like infection, measles, mumps, that can lead to a developmental problem in babies. So these are the things which can affect the neonate or that baby, that female child, if she is a female child, and that may lead to these type of congenital defects in that neonate or fetus. So these are the causes, major causes for congenital malformations. Now, what are the congenital diseases which we see in gynec? First one is congenital diseases of vagina. In that, first is vaginal agenesis. Second is failure of vaginal fusion. Next is absence of vagina. Other is defective hymens, or we called it as imperforated hymen. Because of imperforated hymen, there is during her menstruation age, patient have normal menstrual cycle, patient have menstrual bleeding, but the hymen is imperforated, it is intact, it is tough. So the menstrual blood get collected into the vaginal cavity, and that causes severe pain for that girl, and it is called as hematopulpus, that is collection of menstrual fluid into the vaginal cavity, that is hematopulpus. Vaginal agenesis means there is lack of development of vagina, and because of this that there is usually these are the things usually seen during the puberty age, or can be diagnosed during the puberty age. So, agenesis of vagina, there is failure of fusion of vagina, hymenal defects are defective, imperforated hymen, that is hematopulpus like condition. So, these are the major diseases or common diseases found at the external genital organ, congenital diseases of vagina. These diseases are usually expressed as during puberty, as we had seen that girl may have menstrual problems, there may be absence of menstruation, that is primary amenorrhea, patient or the girl does not have menstruation. Secondly, there may be painful menstruation, there is pain during menses, but there is no visible bleeding. Again, there may be irregular bleeding, irregular menses. So these are the complaints from patient. On examination, we can find the imperforated hymen or hematopulpus. If it is seen, it is like a large balloon. It is tense balloon, red colored, and if we ruptured it, there is severe bleeding. So we have to be very careful by examination of this patient. So on local examination, we can find these things. And for confirmation, we have to do the investigation, that is USG. On USG, we can see if there is a proper development of vagina, if there is absence of vagina, if there is improper fusion of vagina. USG can be done by two ways, either it is abdominal or it is vaginal. So we can decide the type of USG on the condition. Usually all the other conditions or obstetric conditions are diagnosed by the abdominal USG. But these types of condition in gynec, especially when we are diagnosing the external genital organ defects, at that time we can have the transvaginal USG. Depending on the condition, we have to be very clear about the hematopulpus or imperforated hymen. If hymen is very intact and it is tough, then we cannot do the transvaginal sonography. So depending on the condition of patient, we have to decide the type of USG. So for after confirmation, there is no menstrual fluid collection, there is no hematopulpus, we can have the transvaginal sonography. In that we can see the exact picture of vagina, whether there is a complete development of vagina, presence of vagina, fusion of vagina, all these things we can see on the USG. So investigations are these types of investigations, and treatment is mainly, these conditions are congenital condition, so they need to be repaired by surgically. So these are surgically repaired conditions. If it is hematopulpus, that is collection of menstrual fluid in the vaginal cavity, and hymen is tough, at that time we have to give the general anesthesia to that girl and then drainage of that menstrual fluid by proper technique, and we remove the menstrual fluid. But it should be done under the proper anesthesia, proper guidance. Other things, vaginal urgenesis, improper fusion, all these things need to be surgically correction. These things are corrected by plastic surgery usually, and again they are followed by the hormonal treatment. These are the things which are common for congenital diseases for vagina. Second type is congenital diseases of uterus. These are the major diseases seen in girls. In that first category or class 1 diseases are hypoplasia or defective development or less development or improper development, that we call as hypoplasia. That is the class 1. Class 2 is unicornate uterus. That is the class 2. Class 3 is the uterine development is improper, or it is the bisegmental development of uterus, that is we called it as didyphys uterus. That is the class 3. Class 4 is bicornuate uterus, and class 5 is septate uterus. Class 6 is arcuate uterus, and class 7th is it is the abnormality which we called it as DES, that is the diethyl stilbestrol, that is DES, that syndrome is called as DES. So these are the six types of classes where we divide the uterine abnormalities from class 1 to class 6, and they are actually given by the American Fertility Society. So they are AFS classification of the uterine abnormalities. So these are the classification of congenital uterine diseases. We will see about the uterine abnormalities. In that first one is class first is hypoplasia. That is the improper development of uterus or incomplete development or incomplete growth of uterus, that we called as hypoplasia. Complete growth is not seen in these types of diseases, so that is hypoplasia. Second type is unicornate uterus. That unicornate uterus is the abnormality where the part of uterus is one part or single side of uterus is not developed completely. I mean, uterus have bicornuate uterus and unicornuate uterus. These are the two categories we can see. Unicornuate uterus, in that usually there is unilateral incomplete development of uterus. That means one side of uterus, or you can say a portion of uterus which is maldeveloped or which is not properly grown. See, the uterus or the fundus of uterus, body of uterus is, you can assume now, uterus, the shape of uterus, the body of uterus, fundus of uterus and the lower segment, that is cervix. So all these things have to be grown uniformly. If one part of uterus grows completely and the other segment or other part of uterus remains undeveloped, that means it is not the complete development of uterus. So uterus or growth of particular organ, consider uterus, consider any organ in body, that organ should have complete development from all the angles, starting from its lower segment to upper segment, or complete circumference should be developed. But when there is incomplete development, a portion or part of that organ is not developed, we called it as a partial development, and in this type we called it as a unicornuate uterus, that is one single side of uterus is not developed. So that is class 2nd, unicornuate uterus. Class 3rd is diaphyse uterus. This condition is it is complete lack of fusion. Uterus in congenital life, during the development of that fetus, various types of organs are fused together to form a complete structure of that organ. But during this congenital period of that fetus or that girl, there is incomplete fusion of a uterus or any organ in body. But particularly in this condition, when we are seeing the genital organ problems in uterine condition, there is uterus diaphyse is the there is complete lack of fusion of Mullerian ducts from which uterus grows. So there is lack of fusion, various parts of uterus fuse together to form a complete body of uterus. So in this condition there is lack of fusion to develop the complete growth of uterus. So it is the fusion defect. Then class 4 is bicornuate uterus. Bicornuate uterus, that means there is varying the degrees of fusion of the muscle wall. That means uterus, as I had said, there is fusion of the various parts of uterus during the congenital life. See, for this we have to just check the neonatal phase of fetal life. From chorionic tissue, a baby's organs or baby develops from, or neonate develop from the part of tissues, and from the group of tissues or bunch of tissues, various parts of neonate starts to develop. Usually this uterus or genital organs are arising from the Mullerian ducts. These are the group of cells or group of tissues that gives rise to complete structure of uterus. So as previously also, there is a lack of, as we had said, there is complete lack of fusion of Mullerian duct. And in bicornuate, there is a varying degree of fusion. Like in one segment, there is complete fusion. In another segment, there is lack of fusion. On upper side of uterus, the fusion is complete, but on the lower side, there is incomplete fusion. So there is a varying degree of fusion is seen during the development, during the congenital development of that female. So it is the defective fusion of uterus. So it is called as bicornuate uterus. Next is septate uterus. Septate uterus means in this type of uterus, there is a formation of septum. This Mullerian duct forms a septum in between the uterus. And because of this septum, uterus is blocked. This is actually, commonly it is a transverse, maybe vertical septum. Depending on the Mullerian duct fusion, the septum may be transverse or vertical. So it divides the uterus on upper segment and lower segment, or left and right side. So there is the septate uterus, means there is formation of septum from the Mullerian duct in between the uterine walls, and that causes blockage of uterus. Uterus is blocked because of this septum. And if there is septum, as we can understand, there is menstruation problem. During menstruation, patient have severe bleeding. Patient have menstruation, because of the septum also menstrual fluid can flow. So patient have menstruation, but there is severe degree of pain during menstruation. Important is fertility problems are seen because there is septum, so there is transportation of ovum and sperm is not possible in uterus because uterus is blocked by this septum. So patient have usually infertility. So this is diagnosed during the reproductive age. So that is septate uterus. There is formation of septum from Wallerian duct in the uterus. Next is arcuate uterus. This is actually a rare condition. But this is also a defect which is seen and developed during the congenital life. That is arcuate defect. It is also the fusion defect. And next is, last is we had seen DES. That is DES related abnormality. This is actually various types of diseases are seen together. And this syndrome develops, like in vagina there may be adenoids, in cervix there may be cervical abnormality, cervical collar or cervical developmental defects are seen, uterus there may be hypoplasia, in fallopian tube there also may be abnormality, in fallopian tube may be congenital obstruction and all. And together all abnormalities of genital organ, right from uterus, fallopian tube, cervix, vagina, this is called as DES. So that is the congenital abnormality of all the genital organs, that is diethyl stilbestrol syndrome. So these are the various categories of uterine diseases in congenital life. Now actually the clinical features we had discussed, mainly it is related with menstrual problem. Again, if there is uterine development or uterine hypoplasia, that is lack of development of uterus, it will affect the secondary sexual characters of that girl. So during her puberty life, there may be lack of the secondary sexual characters are seen. So patient may have primary amenorrhea because of uterine hypoplasia. Naturally, in bicorneate uterus, unicorneate uterus, because of defective fusion, uterus is not grown completely. That girl have menstrual problems. Usually these patients have primary type of amenorrhea. Patient does not have menstruation. Only in septate uterus, I told you, there is menstruation, but it is dysmenorrhea, severe pain. All other categories will be under primary amenorrhea. All the girls complain there is absence of menstruation. If at all there is menstruation, there is pain during menstruation, there is irregular menstruation. So main complaint regarding this disease is menstrual problems. Second complaint again will be regarding the fertility. Patient will have infertility during her reproductive age. If during puberty she have menses, maybe because of these factors patient may have dysmenorrhea, metrorrhagia, menorrhagia, but she have regular menses. So these diseases will come to know at the reproductive age when there is lack of conception, a failure of conception, there is infertility. Because infertility is seen because of the septate uterus, if there is transverse septum in the uterus, if there is bicorneate uterus, if there is any other hypoplasia or slight improper development of uterus, so that all things we can notice during the reproductive age. So infertility or failure of conception will be the second complaint. Other complaints are, as we discussed, secondary sexual characters may not be developed because of the improper development of uterus. There may be hormonal imbalance also. So all these things are associated with these types of diseases. Important are menstrual complaints, primary amenorrhea, dysmenorrhea, metrorrhagia, maybe menorrhagia, and in reproductive age, infertility. So these are the main complaints. If at all obstetrical complaints are also associated with this, if at all patient have menstruation with menstrual disorder, patient have fertility in that is conception, patient may become pregnant, but during pregnancy again chances of abortion, chances of again abnormal pregnancies, chances of various types of abnormalities during pregnancy. So all these things we can notice during her obstetric life. Patient may have preterm labor, prolonged labor, obstructed labor because of this uterine abnormalities. Abortion is very common, mid abortions are very commonly seen. Placental problems can be seen after delivery, retained placenta, placental perforation. All these things are very common in these types of abnormality. So these are the clinical features at the gynec and obs level. And diagnosis is depending on the condition. If she is a girl, she will have primary amenorrhea, she is complaining of absence of menstruation, then we have to evaluate her according to her history, proper general examination, USG. If necessary, we can advise for transvaginal USG and laparoscopy. So, in laparoscopy, we can easily see the septum, growth of uterus, if there is septum or if there is any abnormality in the uterus, we can see in laparoscopy, and we can treat also. If there is septum, we can remove that septum with laparoscopy. So, investigations are abdominal USG, transvaginal USG and laparoscopy, depending on the condition. During her reproductive age, if infertility, again the investigation will be same. We will go one by one. USG, we will advise first abdominal USG. In that we can see the size of uterus, the direction of uterus, whether it is antiverted, whether it is retroverted, how are the ligaments of uterus and other structures we can see in abdominal USG. If we are not satisfying with this abdominal USG, we can have the transvaginal USG. In that we can see the exact cervical problems or growth of cervix or other things in vaginal USG. If not, we can advise for laparoscopy. In laparoscopy, we can see the uterus from inner side also. Along with that, we can advise the blood investigation, hormonal assessment we can do for FSH, LH, estrogen, progesterone. These are the investigations we can advise. And depending on the condition, we advise the treatment. Usually, again, these conditions are surgical conditions, so we can treat them according to their spread. If there is septum, we can remove that septum with laparoscopy, as I had said. Other things also can be corrected by surgical methods. If necessary, we can give the hormonal treatment. So, these are the congenital diseases of uterus. Now, other rare diseases or uncommon diseases are congenital diseases of fallopian tube. Usually, these types of diseases are very rare, and they are just for your reference, elongation of fallopian tube. In some females or in some girls, the fallopian tubes are elongated, and because of elongation, they have problems during their fertility period, during reproductive age. Patient have infertility. Because if there is elongation of tube, then transportation and ovum and sperm is not easy, and so usually patient have infertility. Other diseases are, there is diverticuli in the fallopian tube. This is also congenital disease, developmental defect. During the fusion of tubes, there may be diverticuli which is seen inside the tube lumen, as tubes are very small, and if there is diverticuli in the tube, tubes are blocked. So again, patient will have infertility as there is no transportation of ovum and sperm. So these are the main condition. Important is this diverticula can lead to ectopic pregnancy, that is the fertilization of ovum and sperm in the fallopian tube. Because of the diverticula, this pregnancy cannot be transported from tube to uterus. So important congenital diseases of fallopian tube are elongation and diverticula. These are the things which are seen in the fallopian tube. In ovaries, congenital diseases of ovary is usually gonadal dysgenesis. There is a problem in the ovary which is called as gonadal dysgenesis. There may be very rare disease, that is accessory ovary. Usually there are two ovaries on the right side and left side, but in some condition there is accessory ovary. This is a congenital disease which is again developmental disease from the tissues of the ovarian tissues. They actually start to grow, and there is growth of two ovaries, bilateral ovaries are developed. But in some girls there is again a development of extra ovary, that is we called as accessory ovary. This ovary is not important, and this is actually non-functional ovary, and usually this is removed in reproductive life. Unless and until it is not, the patient is not symptomatic, actually we doesn't come to know whether there is accessory ovary or not. But usually patient have complaints related to menstruation, related to infertility like complaints. So we can diagnose this condition on the abdominal USG. So treatment is that removal of ovary with laparoscopy. These are the congenital diseases which we can see in the gynec. This is actually short notes are asked for these types of diseases. So congenital diseases seen in female, important are vaginal diseases, uterine diseases, and rare are the tubal diseases and ovarian diseases.